proving to my neighbors I'm just as crazy as they think I am. Welcome again to Music Basics with Ballard. This is episode 3, Musical Vocabulary. Before I get started, I'm going to introduce you to two of my friends. This is Simba and this is Gizmo. There was a blanket on the couch that they both decided to take a nap on, and I don't want to remove them, so they're going to be in the video sleeping behind me today. So you can say hi to them in the comments down below. I'm sure they would love it. Before we get started, I want to talk to you about the fact that this is supposed to be distance learning for my students, and because it's distance learning for my students, I will be hiding code words into today's lesson for them to put into something for their class later on. That's what those are, strange random words are in these videos. You've probably seen them in episodes 1 and 2, and they're continuing on today, but I wanted to make sure you were aware of that. So with that being said, we're gonna get right into it. We're going to be using 10 terms today that you find in music all the time, every day, in almost every corner of the globe. And these 10 terms all do happen to be in Italian. And you might be asking, why Italian? Well, it's Italian because when music started getting written down, it started way back in the 1100s with a man by the name of Guido d'Arezzo. And Guido d'Arezzo started writing music on a 5-note staff because he had been teaching music using his hand. And he eventually turned that music hand over and created the 5-staff line that we are used to today. And he is the one who is credited with that from 1100. And then because music started being written down in Italy when the Renaissance hit around 1300, and then moving straight on into the Baroque period, some of the most prolific composers were from Italy and Italian descent. So that is why a lot of the words we find today are in Italian, because Italian composers of the day wanted to tell the people playing their music, well, this is what I want you to do here. And they just started writing it into the music so that it would leave less to the imagination and more to be what the composer intended. One of the things that you need to understand about these words is that our 10 words today, 5 of them are going to control speed of playing or tempo. That word you might have heard before. Tempo is the word for speed in music. And 5 of the words are going to control style of playing. And those two can be interchangeable, but they usually are interchangeable by putting the words together. So today we're going to use 5 words that control speed and 5 words that control style of playing. Now, style of playing needs a little bit more explanation. Style of playing is giving you instructions on how to make it sound, not controlling anything about the tempo. They, like I said, they often can go together, but style words control something specific about the way it sounds and making sure to give a specific instruction on how it's supposed to be played. The final thing you need to know before we get started with our musical vocabulary is that you will hear 2 examples of every single piece. The first example will be an example of me playing This Land Is Your Land by Woody Guthrie in multiple different speeds and multiple different styles so that you can hear the difference having continuity from one word to the next. The other example will be an example of famous literature that uses that exact word for that exact purpose. Now again, it is very difficult to find music that doesn't have words combined together like I was talking before, but I tried my best to find examples that did that. But because that is so hard, I decided to try to play a few pieces for you of examples where you can hear a specific song played in those different styles so you can hear how those words affect how that song sounds. Let's get started. Here is an example of This Land Is Your Land being played exactly the way it's written on the page. Take a listen. Our first first word today is maestoso. Maestoso means simply majestic, big, loud, and grand. And oftentimes, maestoso is used with coronation marches or things that are involved with royalty or many different things. There's a very famous maestoso segment at the very end of Star Wars in the throne room scene. You should check that one out. So maestoso sounds like this. Did you hear how maestoso it was? How big, loud, and grand, and regal "This Land Is Your Land" sounded? Well, there's no better example of maestoso, in my opinion, than Igor Stravinsky's The Firebird Suite finale. Take a listen. It gives me chills every time. Did you hear it? Big, loud, grand, and just gorgeous. By the way, if you got goosebumps from that, that is called frisson. I get frisson from that piece of music, regardless of when I hear it, where I am, whatever I'm doing, I love it. I get goosebumps. It's such a gorgeous piece and an excellent example of maestoso. I hope you enjoyed it. Our first speed word of the lesson today is ritardando. Ritardando means to slow down. It means to slowly take the tempo and start at one speed and end at another, and slowing it down between those two points, generally gradually. Ritardando is often used to get louder, which we'll talk about later what that word is, and it's often used in combination with many other things. But ritardando means to slow down. You actually might have been able to identify that word because if you ever heard of things being flame retardant means that they slow down fire. So it's the same kind of concept. When something's ritardando in a piece of music, it is slowed down. Here's the example of "This Land Is Your Land" slowing down. Did you feel it? Did you feel the tempo getting slower? That's exactly what ritardando is supposed to sound like. However, I'm going to let one of the greatest composers of all time, in my opinion, John Williams, show you through the piece of music, The Cowboys, from the movie of the same name. Take a listen. Yeah, you can't miss the slowdown in that. Ritardando, slow down, our first speed word of the day. Speaking of firsts, our first passphrase of the evening is going to come through here, and that is Mickey. So our first passphrase today for my students is Mickey. Our next musical style word is called crescendo. Crescendo means, very simply, get louder. It's rather simple. You start at one volume and you end at a volume that's louder, just like turning up the volume knob on your stereo. Rather simple. Here we go. Take a listen to "This Land Is Your Land" with crescendo. I'm sure you heard that. Crescendo is one of the style words that is the easiest to hear. You can almost always tell when something's getting louder. The example we're going to use from literature is one of my favorites. It is Fire of Eternal Glory by Dmitri Shostakovich, a Russian composer. However, this one's being played by one of my favorite brass lines of all time, the Phantom Regiment. Take a listen to this one. You can't miss that crescendo. Oh my goodness, how amazing was that, right? Anyway, crescendo, get louder. Our next musical term is probably needing no introduction, and that is presto. Presto means very fast. Pretty simple. You do something, you want it done presto, right now. Get it quick. Take a listen to This Land Is Your Land, done presto. I'm sure you heard that, nice and fast, right? Well, nothing is really a good example of presto like the next piece I'm going to play for you. That is the opening sequence to the Porgy and Bess Suite by George Gershwin, also considered to be one of the hardest xylophone pieces ever written. Check this one out. Whenever I watch a xylophonist play that, I just can't believe how fast they have to play it. But there you go, presto. Hope you enjoyed it. Our next term is staccato. Staccato very simply means short and separated. Oftentimes, people like to say the word choppy. I try to avoid the word choppy. I think choppy says something to me musically that just doesn't sound good. I don't want my music to sound choppy. But short and separated, that's much better. So another example of what short and choppy might sound like is when your mom gets mad at you for not cleaning your room. I told you to clean your room! Yeah, you all know what that sounds like. Anyway, so here is This Land Is Your Land played staccato. You're able to hear how short and separated that was in that playing of This Land Is Your Land. You could probably hear how there's space between the notes, and that's what we're looking for, short and separated. Now, there's no greater example of that short and separated than Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky's March of the Toy Soldiers from the Nutcracker Ballet. Take a listen. See, I told you that you would recognize it, and now you really know what staccato sounds like. So again, staccato. Our next style term is diminuendo. Diminuendo means to slowly turn the volume down or to diminish the volume. You see how that word became one in English? Yeah, diminish or dim the lights. It's the same concept as diminuendo. That's where some of our words come from. It's pretty awesome to know that kind of stuff. Take a listen to This Land Is Your Land with diminuendo. Mm-hmm. hope you're able to hear the volume turning down and getting softer as it went through that diminuendo in This Land Is Your Land. Now, the example I'm going to play for you for diminuendo is one of my personal favorites. It comes from West Side Story. It is the mambo to the cha-cha in Leonard Bernstein's show. And that music, in my opinion, is one of the greatest examples of diminuendo because it also is telling the story. The mambo is this energetic, loud, in-your-face dance-off between the Sharks and the Jets. And when Maria and Tony meet for the very first time, the world melts away and you're left with the cha-cha. And it sounds so incredible. That diminuendo does everything for that piece of music. Take a listen. Could you feel it? That diminuendo was everything to that piece of music. Leonard Bernstein knew exactly what he was doing. Again, diminuendo, get softer. Pretty awesome. Our next tempo word is adagio. Adagio is really simple. It means slow. That's it, slow. Now, I said that in the beginning. A lot of times, some of these terms are often one thing and what they are, but adagio really just means slow. And you have to combine it with another word in order to make it do the other things. So remember, adagio just means slow. Take a listen to a portion of This Land Is Your Land played adagio. Did you hear that? Slow, This Land Is Your Land. I agree with you. It's not the way that song is supposed to sound. It sounds really weird. Anyway, the song that doesn't sound weird at that tempo is one of my personal favorites. It is Adagio for Strings by Samuel Barber, who also happens to be one of my personal favorites because he wrote most of his music in the town where my university that I went to school was, Westchester University in Westchester, Pennsylvania. Take a listen to Adagio for Strings, which translates technically to slow for strings. Enjoy anyway. Isn't that glorious? Oh, it's just so amazing. The control that those string players have to have is just incredible. Samuel Barber actually took that piece and turned it into a vocal piece later on called Agnus Dei. You should check that one out too. Just as gorgeous. That one was used in a video game from when I grew up called Homeworld. Also awesome. And one of the best uses of that song I have ever heard. Again, adagio, slow. By the way, now I think it's a good time to slip in the second of the three passwords for my students, and that is mouse. Again, mouse is our second word. Our next term is a style word that actually is going to be a little bit difficult to hear. This is one of the hardest. It is legato. Legato, the definition of, is smooth and connected. The very opposite of staccato that we had earlier. By smooth and connected, it means that one note melds into the next. It's really hard to hear, but see if you can hear it in This Land Is Your Land. Did you hear it? I hope you did. It's really difficult to kind of hear. Those notes just kind of flow one note into the next. Now, a lot of times, legato music is also adagio, the word we just learned. And I could easily just play Adagio for Strings for you again. I probably would love to, but actually, I'm going to play a song that I also love. That is Nessun Dorma from the opera Turandot by Giacomo Puccini, sung by the late, great Luciano Pavarotti. Did you hear it? Smooth and connected. Every note flows into the next, and no one really was able to do it any better than Luciano Pavarotti. That song might actually sound familiar to you because it was used recently in one of the Mission Impossible movies as the trigger for the assassin to pull the trigger on her sniper rifle for a certain sequence of the film. Check it out. It's pretty awesome how they use that piece of music. For those of you who like to say that opera is boring, I want to say that you really need to watch Turandot. Turandot starts with a man getting his head chopped off. It's not exciting. Again, that's one of our more difficult terms to hear, legato, smooth and connected, the opposite of staccato. Our last two terms we're going to learn are both tempo words, the first of which is accelerando. That word actually may look rather similar to a word you probably already know, and that means to accelerate or go faster. You start at one tempo and you gradually speed up to another one, and you end up accelerando. It's a great way to do it. Listen to This Land Is Your Land, accelerando. I'm sure you're able to hear that. Tempo getting faster is one of the easiest things for the human brain to comprehend, and it actually is because of your heart. Your heart beats when you're at rest around 50 to 70 beats per minute, so 60 beats per minute is the average. And when things start going faster than your heart, your head notices, because your head subconsciously doesn't want your heart speeding up with it. It's kind of an interesting thing. And so you actually notice tempo changes going faster because your brain thinks harder on keeping your heart at that 60 beats per minute. Pretty cool, right? Well, anyway, talking about more accelerando, an excellent example of accelerando in classical literature is In the Hall of the Mountain King by Edvard Grieg from his Peer Gynt suite. Check it out. Any of you who have ever seen the Smurfs would recognize that as Gargamel's theme, but it's actually called In the Hall of the Mountain King. And you heard it speed up right there. It's pretty impressive how easy it is to hear once you know what an accelerando is. Again, accelerando, speeding up. Our final word of the day is also our last tempo word, and that is allegro. Allegro means simply walking pace. And if you're having trouble remembering that, it's really good to notice that the word leg is hidden right there in the middle. So allegro, walking pace. Helps you remember it, doesn't it? Now, we're going to do a little bit something special here for allegro with This Land Is Your Land. Oh my God, I am such a goober. Anyway, you might have guessed it that allegro tempos are often used in marches. So if something is called March of Something, like March of the Toy Soldiers, like we heard earlier, generally those are performed at an allegro pace. Here's an example of a tune at an allegro pace. It is actually our national march performed by the United States Marine Corps President's Own Band. Before we conclude today, I want to make sure I give my kids their final word of the three-code passphrase, and that is club. Yep, that's right, club. So there you have it, our 10 terms today for our standard Italian musical vocabulary. You had your five style words: maestoso, ritardando, crescendo, diminuendo, and legato. And you had your five tempo words, which were ritardando, presto, adagio, accelerando, and allegro. Hopefully, all those terms now help you perform your music better. I hope you've had a great time, and I enjoyed sharing this with you. So, until next time, see ya, bye. Want to be a YouTube star, Simba? Simba, say hi to everybody. Be a YouTube star. Yeah. See you, bye.